Remember, fans, to log on to fanspointofview.com, the website where you can find out more about your favorite professional athletes. And remember, fans, you can also order your favorite sports memorabilia all on fanspointofview.com.
Live from the Walla Walla Studio is Must Take Football 2005. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. We're here in beautiful Manhattan Beach, California at the Walla Walla Stadium, and we are here bringing you top-notch high school playoff action. Tonight, your 9-1 Mustangs take on the Palmdale Falcons in the first round of the Division III CIF playoffs. Of course, the Mustangs finished this year, as I mentioned, with that 9-1 record. They were led on the ground by Charles the Wolf Wolfgram with his 1,186 yards on the ground, but even more impressive than the number of yards total is his average, 8.4 yards per carry and 13 rushing touchdowns. Of course, that combined with his one receiving touchdown gives Charles 14 touchdowns total. Of course, the Mustangs in the air were led by quarterback Kevin Romero with his 2,190 yards passing, 26 touchdowns, and 13 interceptions. Those yards primarily were going to Bruce Robinson, Ian Walmer, and Will Touchdown Bullock. Jeremy, of course, Palmdale, certainly not a team we're accustomed to seeing. We don't know that much about them. What can you tell us about the Palmdale Falcons?
Well, Chris, this is a battle of number two seeds, as Maricosta represents the Bay League and Palmdale represents the Golden League. Also, this is the first of three Bay League versus Golden League matchups we have this evening. Over in West Torrance, we have Peninsula going up against Highland, the one versus three seeds, and then in Antelope Valley we have Losinger going up against Antelope Valley. So this will be an interesting matchup between two leagues that don't see too much of each other.
And this game is officially started. Palmdale will return, and they are not going to return far at all. Mustangs stop Palmdale. That's number 85 for the Mustangs. Of course, that's Madison DeBruff coming up with the big tackle at the 16-yard line. Palmdale will start with a lot of field ahead of them. Palmdale in a I formation, and it's a straight handoff. Bruce Robinson with the tackle, only 1 yard gained. Rodney Trim with at quarterback for Palmdale. Second down now and 10 for the Falcons. Quarterback Trim now in shotgun. Tight formation. He's looking deep. He's looking deep right. He throws deep right, and it is incomplete. Great coverage out there. Looks like that may have been either Alex Probosco or Eric Mueller out there on coverage. In fact, that was Eric Mueller on the coverage. Great job, step for step with the receiver. Meantime, now on third down, Palmdale keeps it on the ground, and they do get enough for the first down. That's Dominic Blood with the carry.
Great diving tackle by Charles the Wolf Wolfgram, making that shoestring tackle.
Palmdale now on first and 10. We're here in the first quarter. Palmdale with their first drive and the game's first drive. And it is a handoff again. Charles Wolfram with another big hit. Dominic Blood again with the carry.
Yeah, Chris, that one looked like a wrestling move. The old bulldog. British bulldog, if I'm not mistaken.
Meantime now, Palmdale on second and one. Palmdale's in the air, and it's complete. And wow, somehow avoiding the tackle. Amazing balance shown by Palmdale's receiver. That's number four, Brandon McLaughlin. Brandon did a great job to make sure he got enough of the first and then some. Got about 5 extra yards. Mustangs finally bring him down. Ball spotted at the 49-yard line. Quarterback Trim on the handoff. And oh, big tackle for a loss. Bruce Robinson coming in on the blitz. Read it well and makes the big tackle. 3-yard loss for Palmdale. That's going to bring up second. I'm going to go ahead and call that second and 12 for the Falcons. Quarterback Trim now in shotgun. 4 receivers, 3 to his right, 1 running back in the backfield. Trim looking left. He hits his that one running back in the backfield who is finally brought down. Mustangs not fooled at all by that play. Tim Mobley involved in that tackle. Third down and long now for the Falcons. And oh, stretching out. Nice second effort by Rodney Trim, the quarterback. Kept it on his own and literally stretched out enough for that first down. Palmdale keeps the chains moving. Ball spotted at the 40-yard line, first and 10. Trim in shotgun under pressure. Releases and hits his running back, but for basically no yards at all. Charles the Wolf Wolfram was all over him there. Second and 10, Falcons. Good pressure by the Mustangs defense on that last play. Quarterback Trim and shotgun again. Now under pressure again and is able to complete to his receiver who is still on his feet making positive yards. He's trying to cut back and has cut back and is going to get in the end zone. That's number 7, Dominic Blood, with his third reception of this contest and gets the first touchdown of the game. And the kick is up straight and good. That makes the score of this contest 7-0. Of course, we're here in the first quarter and the Mustangs have yet to touch the ball. Already trailing 7-0. And the short kick is finally taken. Mustangs will take over first and 10 for their first possession. There's Madison DeBruff being helped off the field. I hope he's okay. He's certainly a big target for quarterback Romero. Meantime, Mustangs open this drive and they open it on the ground. Charles Wolfram with the carry straight up the middle. From now on second down and he gets the first. Bill Favre, regardless of what sweater you're wearing, move those chains because it's a first down for the Mustangs. Miles Wolfram now on his third carry of this game, and he is dragging Falcons along with him. Another first down, first and 10 Mustangs. Romero now in shotgun. He's looking to throw, he does throw, and he has a man open. Will touchdown, Bullock scores. Mustangs get the first touchdown of their night. It's Will touchdown Bullock from quarterback Kevin Romero. Kick is up high, straight and good. The score is now tied 7 apiece here in the first quarter.
That was a real nice offensive play all around, Chris, because you saw the great offensive line blocking, giving Kevin Romero all the time in the world to find a streaking Will touchdown Bullock across the middle, and then the rest is history in the end zone touchdown.
Of course, Will earned that nickname by averaging a touchdown every 2.4 receptions. Meantime, Palmdale, who was very impressive on their opening drive, takes the field for their second possession of the evening. First and 10 play. And it's a pitch to Dominic Blood, who is still on his feet, finally knocked down. Dominic Blood has certainly shown some amazing balance and coordination already in this contest. He's going to be a tough person to bring down as the night progresses. And a flag on the play. That's one way to get a little bit of help to the defense. It looks like they are working on Madison's ankle. And it looks like they are preparing to ice it, hopefully tape it up later on. Hopefully Madison can go. We'll have to wait and see. Meantime, Palmdale's quarterback Trim runs a little QB keeper, but that flag is going to bring that one back even further now. Unless the coaching staff looks like they are considering declining the penalty. In fact, they do. They'll take the way that play unfolded. Smart choice. That brings up a second and 14 now. Passes in the air and it's complete. Nice reception. Boy, these Palmdale receivers are very elusive, very challenging to bring down. That was number 22, Tyrese House, with the reception. Palmdale in a four receiver set shotgun. We've seen a little bit of everything formation wise already from Palmdale. Now it's a form of an option, kind of an option pass as opposed to an option pitch. Works for about 5 yards. That's going to bring up second down now, second and about 5. Palmdale has already crossed the 50, ball spotted at the 45. We're here, score tied 7-7 in the first. Palmdale's quarterback is under pressure. He scrambles, he gets away, and he gets positive yardage. Rodney Trim with a nice run. Let's wait and see how much he got. Looks like he did get, in fact, he did get enough for the first down, just stretching out. Ball's now spotted at the 40-yard line, first and 10. It's a handoff. Little crossover pattern with the running backs. Tyrese House ended up with the ball, and another first down for the Falcons. Trim and shotgun. And it's a handoff to Blood, who gets more positive yardage and what looks to be another first down for the Falcons. Trim now looking to pass, again under pressure, and again he gets away from the pressure. Mustang linebackers are going to have a very difficult night on pass plays because they're going to want to watch their coverage responsibilities. But man, you cannot take your eyes off of Rodney Trim, because if that quarterback scrambles, he can get positive yardage on his own. Uh-oh, looks like the ball may have popped down. Mustangs say it did and say they recovered. And officials are saying otherwise. Officials say it's still Falcon football. And it was enough for the first, so it's first and goal, Falcons. Two impressive drives so far by the Falcons. Quarterback Trim dives forward, and he's in for the score. Falcons get on the scoreboard for the second time this evening. 13-7 is the score right now. The point after attempt is up. It's high enough, it's straight enough, and it's good. 14-7. After the Mustangs tied the score at 7 apiece, Palmdale jumps back ahead. Mustangs hope to get this one tied up again. Impressive ball control. Uh-oh, that one's not impressive ball control. Palmdale going with the short kick. It fooled the Mustangs. That ball landed in kind of a dead man's highway there. Mustangs were not able to get the ball. Palmdale has recovered. And under pressure is quarterback Trim, but he's scrambling, and he scrambled his way for a first down. He keeps scrambling like that, and he's going to be making himself some eggs pretty soon. Quarterback Trim now. Pumps a couple times, finally throws, and throws incomplete. Was going in the back of the end zone. Trim is very impressive. The 6-foot senior shows a lot of patience in that pocket. Trim now in shotgun on second and goal. And it looked like he intended to keep that one the entire time. The Mustangs did a great job of staying with him. I saw Eric Mueller involved in that, and that will end the first quarter. 14-7 is the score. As we prepare here for the second quarter, of course, the Mustangs trail this contest 14-7. We've seen an impressive offensive performance really by both teams. I mean, that first quarter was essentially three total drives. Both teams doing an excellent job of putting together long drives. Palmdale on their current one, trying to make this score 21-7. Palmdale goes to the air, it's complete, and tackled. Nice tackle out there by Ryan Oliver, because that one absolutely saved a touchdown. He was isolated all by himself. And also prevents, hopefully, another touchdown, as now Palmdale is on fourth down. And fourth down, they run the reverse, and it works for the touchdown. Impressive play call by the coaching staff to take a risk on fourth down to run a reverse.
The Full Moon is out tonight as Palmdale now makes the score of this contest 21-7.
Yeah, Chris, and you know what happens when the Full Moon comes out.
Charles the Wolf Wolfgang. Mustangs now set to return. Of course, let's see what Palmdale does. Palmdale did recover that last possession there as they kicked off. They kicked short. The Mustangs did not recover. Palmdale jumped on what is a live ball. Let's see what happens this time. There was a penalty on that play, which has severely adjusted the kickoff point. Yet Palmdale still keeps that same theory. And oh, Mustangs break this one open. That is gone for the touchdown. Will touchdown bowling this time. Doing it on the return, his first return for a touchdown this season. And oh boy, did the Mustangs need that one to get some momentum back in their favor. Point after attempt is up, straight, and good. That makes the score of this contest now 21-14. Mustangs right back into this game.
Chris, it appears Mr. Momentum has made an appearance on the sideline.
Mustangs now kick off. And this time the Mustangs kick short. Figure if it's working for Palmdale, let's try it ourselves. That play had potential to be disastrous for the Mustangs. As with that high bounce, it really was almost working as if it was a onside kick. If Palmdale could have gotten to that ball first, they would have gotten the ball back. Luckily, however, Will Bullock did a great job of making sure he maintained possession of the ball, and once he saw that open field, touchdown Bullock knows what to do. He knows that end zone well. He's seen it many times this season, and he raced his way in for the score. Meantime now, Palmdale on first and 10. It's a play-action play. Trim is going to the air, and he completes. Completes the Dominic Platt out on the left-hand side. Good enough for a first down. Oh, just shy. Platt apparently hit the sidelines. Going out of bounds this time. Platt now on the carry is tackled nicely by Peter Kurbish. However, it's after first down yardage, first and 10, Falcons. Trim hands off. But again, this time, Blood is met by the entire Mustangs defensive squad. Second and 5, Falcons. Of course, the Mustangs go from Seahawks one week to Falcons the next. Hopefully this game will end in similar fashion. Big play there. Mustangs get the sack. There was a flag down. Let's see what that call is. But meantime, Lucas Noble with a big tackle. And that call was against the Falcons.
Yeah, that reminded me of Justin Reese, a recent Mustang graduate defensive lineman who dominated offensive lines in the past.
Falcons now on third and long. Quarterback Trim. He's dancing, he's looking, he throws, and completes. His receivers have done an amazing job of catching the ball. That time it was number six, Andrew Tony, with the catch. First and 10, Falcons. Ball spotted at the 41. Trim is scrambling. He's looking left, he completes left, dumps it off to his running back, who turns it upfield and gets another first down.
Wow, Chris, both these teams feature similar offenses, so it'll be interesting to see if either defense can really stop either offense.
Yeah, this one's definitely showing the possibility of being a shootout, as now it's Ronald Scott with the carry. Mustangs do a good job against Scott on that play, but he was still able to get six. It's second down and four for the Falcons. We're here in the second quarter. Falcons lead this contest 21-14. It's a fake pitch and a handoff to Andrew Tully right up the middle. And that play works for another first down. First and 10. Hondo putting together yet another impressive drive. They're not getting a lot of 20, 30, 40 yard plays, but they are getting a lot of 7, 8, 9 yard plays. And they just keep moving that chain little by little.
Mark the pass!
This could be a huge down. It's second and 9, but if the Mustangs can come up with the stop and force a third and long, that may prevent Palmdale from getting into the end zone, may force them to a field goal situation, and that is exactly the kind of play they were looking for. Number 55 for the Mustangs, David DiCordova, finishes off the tackle. It looked like number 35, Peter Kubesch, may have gotten the first hit, forcing quarterback Trim to spin, lose his balance, and then DiCordova came and finished him off for the sack. Third and very long now for the Falcons. And again, under pressure, Trim scrambles, has nowhere to run, and the Mustangs knock it down. Great job on defense. Touchdown Bullock gets the bat on that one, but that was really set up nicely by the front group on the Mustangs. They got pressure on Trim, forced him out of the pocket, but they had that secondary help from the linebackers. Trim knew he had nowhere to run and was forced to put it in the air. It looks like they are going to go for it here on fourth down. You're right, Jeremy. They are very similar to the Mustangs' attack. This is exactly what the Mustangs would do. Go for it here on fourth down. Fourth and almost 20. Trim again under pressure. He is scrambling. He is under pressure. He may not get away this time. In fact, he won't. He is sacked on fourth down. Mustangs will take over. First and 10, take over on downs. Thanks to number 80, Ian Burke. Looks like it's getting rough out there on the sidelines for the Falcons. Just as rough as it is on the field as the Mustangs take over now. Charles Wolfgram on the carry, and pop goes the weasel. All of a sudden, he gets about 15 yards on the play that really, I thought he was only going to get about 2 or 3.
You can see why that extra yardage came into play. But as a former lineman, I didn't see any holding.
Meantime, Mustangs on the repeat of first down go back to Charles 12 number one gets to about 4 yards on the play. It's giving up still second and one. No backs in the backfield. Romero completes out to touchdown ball. He's forced out of bounds at about the 30-yard line. He's going to bring up third and one. Romero now back to pass under pressure, gets the ball off to Bruce Robinson, who makes some nifty moves, and Bruce Robinson gets the Mustangs first down. Great job by quarterback Romero, even though he knew he was about to get hammered, to stick in that pocket and complete for the first. Now it's Charles Wolfgram pounding and crawling and clawing his way forward. Gets to just shy of the 30. That's another Mustangs first down. Mustangs finally getting some momentum going here, Jeremy.
Yeah, Chris, the Wolf dragged three defenders 5 yards on that play.
Romero now to the air. He's going deep. He has a man deep. And oh, Bruce Robinson almost made what would have been a remarkable catch. Amazing that he was even able to get a hand on that one. Triple coverage on Bruce. Good attempt. It's nice to see the Mustangs at least take that attempt to go deep downfield. Help keep that defense honest. Meantime, on second down now, Romero has running back screen working. And it's Proposco. He's getting big yardage, and he is in. Oh, just short. I thought he was going to get in, but he was knocked out of bounds just shy of the touchdown. Good attempt. Either way, big play for the Mustangs. First and goal.
And here's the handoff, stopped short. Wow, Chris, I could not believe that tippy-toeing down the sideline by Probosco. I could have sworn he was in for the touchdown.
6'4", 235, and he was showing his speed on that one. Probosco, yeah, athlete on that play. Meantime, Mustang stopped on second. It's third and goal. And this play is stopped as the officials didn't like something. Oh, delay of game against the Mustangs. Rough penalty take down. The ball spotted at the 4 yard line. Now it's at the 9. Mustangs through the goal. Romero's under pressure. He scrambles. He's got some room. He dives. He leaps. We're waiting for the call. I thought he got in, but let's see what the call is. Oh, they did not give it to him. Fourth and goal, Mustangs. Just as we saw Palmdale go for it on fourth down on one end, you can guarantee the Mustangs are going to go for it on this fourth down. Kevin Romero under center. And it's Alex Probosco with the score. Touchdown, Mustangs.
Yeah, Chris, that was fitting as we see the extra point up and good that Alex Probosco finish off that drive with the touchdown plunge as he, in my opinion, was robbed by that official down on that sideline.
Of course, Alex had 3 touchdowns rushing for the Mustangs this season. That now would be his 4th on the grand total for the year. Alex is definitely proving his value in short yardage situations. Good job by the Mustangs on kick coverage, as Palmdale really had nowhere to go. They'll take over on the 25, first and 10. Oh, And the handoff, still on his feet, and turning the corner, Tyrese House finally forced out of bounds. Oh boy, did that one have danger written all over it. We are down to the final minute of this half. This game is tied. This has been an exciting first half. Palmdale trying to do something here before halftime. And oh, somehow Rodney Trim got rid of that ball, but it was incomplete. Second and 10 now for the Falcons. Trim now under pressure. He's starting to get forced out of the pocket. A flag comes down, and he throws the ball away. Let's see what that flag is. Like it is going to be against Palmdale. And it is. It's holding against Palmdale. The penalty is declined. The Mustangs will decline a penalty as it now will force a third and long situation for the Falcons. Good call by the Mustangs coaching staff. Trim and shotgun. Under pressure and brought down, the ball comes loose. No word from the officials. That one absolutely was a fumble. Oh, the officials are not going to allow it. Of course, that's Ian Burke. Good to see Ian using his heads up to jump on that ball. Intentional grounding is the call. However, that does still force a fourth down situation. Fourth and long, Palmdale will have to punt. It's a high punt, a very good punt. It takes a Palmdale roll. Of course, on the Mustang side, the point was not as much to get the ball back, to turn the game over to their offense, as much as it was to make sure Palmdale did not score one more touchdown. Mustangs keep it on the ground, and Charles Wolfram, you can never be too sure when he's in the game. To most teams, that would be just a normal safe play to try to run out the clock. With Charles Wolfram's ability, that's a game breaker. He may have just convinced the Mustangs coaching staff to try to put a little something extra on the board here before halftime. Murray now, rolling left, throwing left, and completes left, and out of bounds. Bruce Robinson doing a great job, excellent concentration to come down for the catch, and they only had 5 seconds off the clock. 15 left to go in this half. Mustangs definitely have something going here. Complete to Greg Gelb. Of course, the clock does stop while the chain moves. Looks like timeout for the Mustangs. Mustangs wisely taking the timeout from what could have been just simply running out the clock to a couple big plays later, and the Mustangs have a chance to do something here before halftime. Romero now with the ball. He's scrambling. He's under pressure. He's still on his feet, and he's finally brought down. It looks like that one's going to do it. In fact, it will. The score is tied 21-21, and it's halftime. Are set for exciting second half. Boy, if this second half is anything like the first half, I hope you have your seatbelt on, fans, because this is going to be an exciting half of high school playoff football. Of course, this score is tied at 21 apiece. At one point, the Palmdale Falcons had it checked out to a 21-7 lead. But the Mustangs crawled their way back and tied it at 21 apiece. Thanks in part to touchdown bullets, two touchdowns in that first half. Meantime, Mustangs get another huge return. One of those two touchdowns by Bullock was on the kick return. This time it's Nick Churkow with the huge return, getting the Mustangs in great field position. Ball spotted at the 45-yard line, their first possession of this second half. Quarterback Romero throws middle and, oh, just incomplete. Good coverage up there. Second and 10 now, Romero hands off this time, Charles Wolfgram. Charles does such a great job of keeping his head low and to the ground. He is a powerful force to bring down and knows how to get in the end zone. Charles is going to have an excellent career wherever he decides to go. Romero now, new timeout, third and five, gets hammered but completes the ball. Ian Wandler with a nice reception, a simple 10-yard in pattern by Ian. But Kevin Romero, for the second time tonight, has really held back in that pocket and waited for his receivers to release their pattern, despite knowing he's about to get hit. Good job by Romero. Now Romero has Ian Wandler wide open. Mustangs touchdown. Nothing tricky on that one. Ian Wandler just lost his coverage. Kevin Romero did a great job of finding him. Wide open, easy touchdown. Mustangs jump ahead in this contest for the first time tonight. Mustangs set to kick off as they jump ahead now 28-21. It's a high kick. Palmdale will have a chance to get some sort of return on it, but not this time. Mustangs drive them down. That looked like that was number seven, Dominic Dunn, with the return, but he was hammered by the Mustangs deep. Quarterback Trim under center. And looks like he did fumble. It was supposed to be a play action play, it looked like. But when Trim was not able to get the ball away from his running back's path, the ball was knocked down. The Mustangs jump on it. They take over first and 10. That could be the play of the game for the Mustangs. Man in motion, Romero under center. Hands off, Charles Wolfram has a hole. Gets down to the 5-yard line. Mustangs edging closer to taking what could be a big 14-point lead. Man in motion again, that's Gelb in motion, and again, it's Charles Wolfram, and he does what he's done his entire career as a Mustang. He gets in the end zone, touchdown, Costa. Point after attempt is up, straight high and good. Mustangs now lead this contest 35-21 and did a great job of capitalizing on a huge turnover by the Palmdale Falcons. Ball keeps bouncing, new time finally picked up, but knocked down immediately. Mike DeSaro looks like the man involved in that tackle. Dominic Blood got literally 1 yard on the return. Great job by DeSaro. First and 10 now, Palmdale. Trim, he's looking everywhere. There's a flag down. Finally completes a pass on the sideline. And that penalty is against the Falcons. It's coming back. Palmdale now on the repeat of first down. They go to the ground this time, and the Mustangs were waiting for it. Alex Wilbosco, among others involved in that play, good job on the front four for the Mustangs. Trim goes to the air and does an amazing job. He actually completes that pass. Andrew Tolley with the reception. Trim was standing in his end zone as he made that pass. Great job to get the ball out there. Palmdale now with the first and 10, and more importantly, his breathing room. Shuffle pass, and uh-oh, that's not working for anything at all. Lucas Noble read that one beautifully and was wrapping number six, Andrew Tolley, on the shuffle pass before he even caught the ball. Second and 10 now for Palmdale. Trim under pressure. He's scrambling. He doesn't know where to go, and he is hammered. Lucas Noble with the second consecutive big play. David DeCordova also involved in that one as the Mustangs come up with a huge sack. Third and long now for the Falcons. Third and 12 to be specific. Trim in shotgun. Mustangs can stop him here. They can force a punt. And it looks like the pass is complete, but well shy of the first. It's going to create a fourth and about four situation. In fact, that is the scenario. Palmdale will have to punt. Mustangs will take over. There is the punt for Palmdale. It's a short punt. Trevor Koppel on the return, but is not able to get anything to the ground. Palmdale did collapse on him rather well. Meantime, Mustangs take over, first and 10. Handoff goes to Bruce Robinson, who was the man in motion, but Bruce was met immediately. Nothing Bruce could do on that one. Mustangs lose about 5 yards on the play. No one's happy with that one. Mustangs will have to adjust now on second down. And it's a handoff to Charles Wolfram, who literally steps and stomps and fights his way forward just to get anything he could. Got about two. So you're down now and long for the Mustangs. Quarterback Romero completes in the middle. It's going to be shy of the first. It's going to create a fourth and four, but given the field position, I'm going to assume the Mustangs are going to punt. In fact, they are. Greg Galb with the reception. Whoa, high snap. Good job by the Mustangs just to get that one down and get a good punt. That takes a friendly Mustangs roll. While finally down at the 23-yard line, Palmdale will take over, though, first and 10. Of course, Palmdale trails 21-35 here in the third quarter. Palmdale starts out on the ground, and Bud is not going anywhere. He's thrown back. He's still on his feet, though. He may be able to get something out of this anyway, and he somehow does. Amazing athleticism shown by number 7, Dominic Blood, as he was trapped for about a 10-yard loss. Instead, it's a 4-yard gain.
That's one of the more incredible 4-yard runs I've seen in a long time.
Trim now in shotgun. He's ready for the snap. He gets the snap. He throws. Throws left. And oh, caught, but hammered. Tim Mobley on the coverage. And boy, did he close quickly. The reception was made for, but for no gain, as Tim Mobley did a great job. Jim now under pressure again. He scrambles. And he dives his way forward, well short of the first. It's going to bring up second and about four. Trim now goes to the air. It's complete to Bud. Dominic Bud is still fighting. Gets out to the 50-yard line. You know, it looks to me, Jeremy, like the Redondo Seahawk has somehow made his way, I suppose in some sort of revenge fashion, made his way back to the sidelines, this time posing as a Falcon. Meantime, Trim is still on his feet. Good scramble, quarterback Trim, he was hammered after an 8-yard gain. Second down and 2, Falcons. And it's an option play that Trim kept all the way. He really did a great job of selling that fake on the handoff to the first back through, opened up ground, and he got another first.
Yeah, Chris, and then downfield, he did a little head fake, sort of like Johnson used to do faked out the defender and got another 5 yards.
Trim now to the air. And, just incomplete. Mustangs had good coverage. It's going to bring up a 2nd and 10. And trim to the air. It bounces, and it's incomplete. That brings up 3rd and 10 now for the Palmdale Falcons. We're here in the third quarter. Mustangs lead 35-21. Quarterback trip and shotgun. Takes a snap. He's looking left. He's rolling left. He's running left. And he is finally brought out of bounds. Ryan Oliver and with number 35, Peter Kurbish, both involved, both did a great job of closing on quarterback trim. That forces a 4th and 6 situation. Palmdale is going for it on 4th down, trailing by 2 touchdowns. Let's see what they do. They keep it on the ground. And the Mustangs had a chance, but an amazingly athletic play, as we've seen all night long from Dominic Flood, literally leaping for the first. That ends this quarter, 35-21, Mustangs lead. And we're here, ready to start the 4th and final quarter. Mustangs lead this contest 35-21, but Palmdale is driving. Palmdale on 1st and, quarterback trim just overshot his receiver. Incomplete, that's gonna bring up now 2nd and 10. One of the very few miscues we've seen tonight from Trim, as he has been excellent in this playoff performance. Trim's beacon up completes. It's close to a touchdown. In fact, they're not giving it to him at all. The official waved his hands as if it was an incomplete pass. I'm not entirely sure how they can rule that. In fact, they have decided now they concurred it is a touchdown. It looked to me like that would have been the proper call. Of course, being a Mustang alumni, I'm certainly not going to argue in favor of that touchdown call. Meantime, the point after attempt is barely good. Palmdale does edge closer, 35-28 is the lead now. Mustangs lead 10-1, touchdown. Jeremy, what have you thought about this game? This has certainly been an exciting one.
Yeah, Chris, that's what you get when you get two seeds. As you're well aware of, the Mustangs are co-league champions. As we see Nick Turkow with a great return up to the Mustangs 45, and I wonder how good Antelope Valley is, the number one seed from the Golden League.
Hopefully we'll get a chance to find out, as Gelb is in motion. The handoff there goes to running back Charles Wolfram. Gets good yardage. That is the 3rd good kick return we've seen tonight from the Mustangs. 2 now by Trickow, and of course 1 earlier tonight by touchdown Bullock that resulted in, of course, a touchdown. Charles Wolfgram now. Oh my goodness! What a stiff arm by Charles Wolfgram. He flattened Brandon McLaughlin. And in all fairness to Charles, that stiff arm earned him another good 2 to 3 yards. I hate to be the defender trying to bring Charles Wolfram down. Meantime, uh-oh, coaching staff going to have a tough call here. It's going to be shy. It's fourth and going to be a full yard. Mustangs come with the big backfield, the elephant backfield, they called it in our day. And it works. Mustangs get the first down. Mustangs would, of course, love to get that lead back to two touchdowns, especially here in the fourth quarter. More importantly, they want to take some time off the clock. Meantime, they have completed Alex Probosco with a wonderful move that works for a touchdown. Second touchdown of the evening for Alex Probosco, as the fans are excited about that one. What a great move. Good job by Romero to get the ball to him, but once Probosco saw the open field in front of him, he made a brilliant cutback and got in for the score.
I almost would have liked to have seen Alex run over one of the DBs back there because of his huge size advantage. Maybe next time.
Of course, that thought was probably in the minds of those defensive backs, which probably helped Alex in that cutback move. I'm sure they were not expecting that at all. Meantime, speaking of cutbacks, Tyrese House with a nice return. Very nice return. Getting out just shy of midfield.
Yeah, Chris, you're next up on the touchdown board.
I think we passed my push-up total a long time ago. Meantime, uh-oh, a little flea flicker. Dipsy Doodle action going on here. Palmdale lucky that one was not picked off, as it was not executed well at all. Mustangs read it beautifully. Ball was knocked down. That's going to bring up a second and 10 situation, but boy, that one could have really worked worse for Palmdale. That's a risky time to run the old flea flicker. Second and 10 meantime, quarterback trip. Dumps it off to his running back, Kristen Gilroy. What is it? One of his first receptions. Sure made that a good one. Got nice yardage. Third down now and about five. Palmdale trailing here in the fourth quarter. Quarterback trim on the scramble, under pressure, tries to do a stiff arm himself, but you're not going to stiff arm number 35, Peter Krubesch. Peter doing a great job of closing on the speedy trim, knocking him down. Trim was able to get even closer to that first down. He is shy. Although the official is now deciding to measure.
There you go.
Still waiting for the official word, and it was enough for the first. First and 10, Palmdale. Go! 42-28 is the Mustangs' lead here in the fourth. Let's see if they can hold on. It's going to be tough, especially with elusive backs like that one, Dominic Blood. Mustangs do a good job of containing him, letting him not break outside. Second and two now for the Falcons. Trimming shotgun. And it's the shuffle pass to Blood. Makes a couple of nifty moves and is still on his feet. Looks like the ball may have come loose, though. That'd be a huge break for the Mustangs if it does. It looks like it did, and it did. Huge turnover. Dominic Blood had made an amazing run, literally dragging Mustangs defenders, but someone got their hand in there, knocked the ball loose. Mustangs will take over on the turnover, first and 10. Couple players down. Let's see who that is. That's Nick Churkow, who, knowing Nick, I'm sure was right in the middle of that pileup and may have been the person who knocked that one loose. And Dominic Blood was the other player, the Palmdale player, who was at the middle of that pileup. And meantime, Charles Wolfram pounds his way through the middle of the offense, first and 10. Kevin Romero, under center, hands off again. I expect to see a lot of Charles Wolfgram now here late in the game. Mustangs lead by two scores, so they don't need more points as much as they do time run off that clock. Of course, Palmdale knowing the same thing. Stacked the D-line pretty heavy on that play, stopping the Wolfman. It's third and 7 now for the Mustangs. The official stopped that play. Penalty delay of game against the Mustangs. One more time to get a delay of game call. Let's see if the Mustangs can recover. And oh, good attempt. At their Crosettes at number 86, Vince Cabone for the Mustangs. Vince, the 6'1 receiver, doing all he could to stretch forward to get closer to that first, but wasn't able to do it. It's 4th and 4, punting situation. Ball is snapped, punt is away. It's a good punt for the Mustangs, but it is returnable. And in fact, Palmdale does a good job, gets about 15 yards on the return. Palmdale will take over, first and 10. Mustang down, looks like that one may be Rams. Mike Matheson being helped off the field. The way they were rubbing his leg there, it looked like that one may have been cramps. I'm hoping that's what it is. Meantime, Palmdale trailing by 2 touchdowns here in the 4th. Go to the air, and oh, number 6, Andrew Tolley must have knew the Mustangs were coming up heavy from behind him, because he was turning his head before the ball got there. Incomplete, 2nd and 10, Palmdale. Quarterback Trim scrambles, throws, and completes right. Kevin Romero, who doubles as quarterback / defensive back, comes up with a monster hit on the sideline, knocking Dominic Blood down hard, but Dominic was able to get the first. 1st and 10, Palmdale. First Mustangs lead right now, 42-28. Here in the 4th, meantime, Palmdale trying to do anything they can to get back into this ball game. Ronald Scott with the reception. 2nd and 2. Palmdale goes to the air again, and it's complete again, but great job. Charles Wolfram really limiting the effectiveness of that play. Palmdale takes timeout.
So we see Coach Ray Lee with some words of encouragement during the timeout. This Palmdale team is quite impressive coming out of the Golden League.
Especially on offense, this is an excellent offensive team with a lot of weapons. Double play action, trim thrown, and almost completed for the touchdown. Brandon McLaughlin was not able to come up with the grab. He had his chance, but could not come up with the catch. Mustangs now will take advantage of that play. That will force a brief third down situation now. Second and 10, and that penalty is against Palmdale. Definitely not the time for Palmdale to be getting a motion penalty. Second and 15 now for Palmdale. Trim on the pump fake. Nothing going for him on that play. Now he lobs it up. And lobs it for the touchdown. Great deal on coverage by the Mustangs. Trim started to make a motion towards the line of scrimmage like he was going to run. Maybe that was enough to bring some of the Mustang DBs up because he's such a threat. And speaking of, on the two-point conversion attempt, he gets in. Interesting call to Jeremy for Palmdale's coaching staff, trailing by 14 to go for a two-point conversion.
I take it they don't want to go to overtime.
I mean, I suppose better to make that attempt now, because then if they, either way, they still need a second score. This way, they at least give themselves a chance to try to make up for any failed attempts on that second score.
Yeah, Chris, I remember that last PAT attempt that barely made it over the crossbar. I guess they figured they're not going to lose the luck this time.
Well, they go for the onside kick here. And it looks like the Mustangs did recover. The conga line has started. The fans are getting excited. They can sense the Mustangs' victory in the air. All the Mustangs have to do now is hold on for the final 2 minutes and 30 seconds, and they will advance to the second round. Charles Wolfgram on the ground for first down. Jeremy, I think I heard the phone ring, and we got some out-of-town scoreboard calls coming in.
Well, Chris, it appears that St. Francis has defeated Downey at Downey this evening, which will set up a second-round matchup with the Mustangs at St. Francis. Mustangs are 1-0 against St. Francis, and the only time they met was in the playoffs at St. Francis, and they have an artificial turf field. So it will be the first time these Mustangs played on artificial turf.
Well, if anything, I like the Mustangs' chances on artificial turf, the way this offense is designed. Of course, there is some Mustang lineage on that St. Francis sidelines. A former St. Francis player, Rex Petrel, is the son of former Mustang head coach Larry Petrel, who I'm sure will be in attendance. Of course, Larry was the coach of both the my junior and senior seasons, leading the Mustangs to what was at that time, back in 89 and 90, their first ever playoff victory coming in the 1990 season. I like to say Coach Petro was the one who really got the framework started. Of course, Coach Morrow came in following Coach Petro, and we know what he's done since then. Meantime, the Mustangs trying to close this contest. Charles Wolfram continues to get the ball right up the middle, doing everything he can to get that first and keep those chains going, and more importantly, keep that clock running.
Yeah, a little Mustang trivia for you, Chris. Larry Petrel, Coach Petrel, was in fact the Mustang coach that started the Mustang saying "Step up."
And in fact, he was the one that engineered the beautiful workout facility and had the word "Step up" up on the wall. One of the first things, I'm sure he's probably in there knowing him, painting the word "Step up" himself.
Yeah, Kristen, as you're aware of, Coach Petrel was a former El Camino Warrior and a USC Trojan. I remember hearing his old Trojan stories after practices, the memories.
Meantime, the Mustangs continue to panic, and that is going to do it. The Mustangs are going to win this game. They will move on to play St. Francis next week. Congratulations, Mustangs. Oh, boy, what a tremendous offensive showing by both teams tonight, Jeremy. What do you think of this victory?
Well, Chris, this Mustang team, as you can see, can play football at a high level with any team, as this Mustang offense has shown that it can score at will, and that Mustang defense to hold that Palmdale offense to only 28 points, I thought was a great job all the way around.
Great job by defensive coordinator Ray Lee with his halftime adjustments, holding Palmdale to only one second half score. Great job coaching, great job players. Congratulations, Mustangs, on the first round victory. I'm Chris Lee for Jeremy Sadowski signing off, and we'll see you next week, round two.